In this tutorial, you will learn how you can use webhooks in Integromat so that you can receive data from any tool you want. It's super duper handy, so let's just dive right in and I'll explain how it works, and then I also want to show you two cool examples. So I just created a new scenario, and the first thing that we want to do is we want to add a webhook module at the beginning, because the webhook module is going to be the trigger for our scenario, so that when the webhook is receiving data, boom, our scenario is going to start. So you just click this module, and then you type in webhook, then down here we find webhooks, and then you see that we have three different things. We have a custom mail hook, custom webhook, and a webhook response. We are going to need the custom webhook. Then down here you find a little drop down, so if you have any existing webhooks, then you can find those over there. But if you do not have those yet, then just click over here add. And then you just give your webhook a name. So this is just for your own reference. I'm just going to call this one example webhook. And then if you want, you can also set an IP restriction if you only want certain tools to access that. Usually I don't really bother with that. You can also set up filters or something like that. So then here I click save. And then you see here that we get our webhook. So this is our long URL. This is the webhook. This is where tools can send data to. And then you see this thing like spinning here. So we can also stop it, but what it is doing right now, it is determining the data structure. So it's waiting for data. So we have to send an example, and then Integromat knows what kind of data it is receiving from that webhook. So just as an example, I'm going to copy this. Then I go to this really simple tool, it's called Postman. And then what I can do here, I can send a post request. And this is basically also how all these tools work. Like they send like a post request, you enter the URL, and then you can also add a key value pair. So you have a key and a value. So for example, that could be name, and then the value of that could be Emma. And then for example, email, the email address could be emmadoe@gmail.com. And then what this also does, it's like adding this as a query string to our webhook. You don't really have to worry about that, but just this is what it's sending over. Then when we click send and we go back over to our scenario, then over here it says successfully determined. So now Integromat knows what kind of data to expect. And what is so cool about this is that you can now use it in your next modules. So when I'm going to click here, okay, and then I, for example, add a Google Sheet module, and then I say, okay, add a row to a Google Sheet. And again, you can just do everything, right? You can also send an email with Gmail. You can, I don't know, add something to your task list. You can basically do anything with Integromat, right? So, but just as an example. So then here, mode, select spreadsheet. Then I'm going to select my spreadsheet. I have a spreadsheet over here. And then I'm going to select sheet, sheet one. Table contains headers, yes, name and email. So that is this spreadsheet over here. So you see here, name and email. So all the things here in the first row, those are our headers basically. And then you see that also here, A is name, B is email. Here, A, name, B, email. So if you want to add any other ones, then it will always correspond with all these letters up there. And then what you can do is you can just go in here, and then you see that the variables from our previous module, so from our webhook module, are showing up inside the next module. So when I hover this, you also see that it's like beating, right? It's like a beating heart, basically, our previous module. So what I could do here, I can say name, then I go to the next one, and I can here set email. So now dynamically, whenever this scenario runs, then the name will automatically go into the column A, and the email will go into column B. So when I click here, okay, then I click here, save. So that's really important. And then now I click run once. So now we're basically going to test this. So we go back over to Postman, and here we send some sample data, and then you see it running here now. So this is the data that we got, name, email. And then in the next step, it says, okay, we updated a row. So now when I go over here, it says email Emma Doe. Now then maybe the first row, you have to like restyle that. So here I just say reset, reset. And then okay, it is set over here. And for example, if we would do this again, so here we would say johndoe@gmail.com. And if I click here again, add run once, and I send more, we go back, then boom, you see instantly this webhook will start and our data is added to our Google Sheet. Now, what you can also do is you can also change this. So now you see this like thunder icon. So that means that whenever it gets data, it will start instantly. And I think that's really cool. This is usually how I use it. But if you want, you can also schedule it. You can, for example, also say, okay, I just want this webhook to start once a day. And then once a day, here every day, check if there's any new data waiting in my webhook query. So you can also do that, but usually I will just leave it to immediately so that whenever you get new data, boom, it will start right away. And then one more thing you can also do is you can also send a webhook response. So you just already I showed you that. Here's when we go to webhook, and then here you see webhook response. So this is how we can let the tool know from where we sent our data over to Integromat, like, hey, everything was okay, send a status 200, and then you can also send something back. So here I would say okie dokie, for example, right? So here I click okay, I click save, run once, and then I'm going to test this again. So now I will type here Vera Do, I click send, and boom, this will start. Data was added to our Google Sheet. And then when we go back here over to Postman, then you also see here status 200 okay. And this is the data that we got back. So these status codes, if you want, you can also change those. Here's, for example, a whole list. I'll also link to this in the description below of this video where you can find all the response codes that are out there. My favorite is 418. I'm a teapot, I have no clue what that is for, but I think it's pretty funny that it is in there at all. But so yeah, that's how you send a webhook response. You don't have to send a webhook response, because if you don't do that, I can also demonstrate that. I'm gonna click here run once, and then the tool, your tool, would send data over. Then you also see here that by default you already get the status 200 awk, and then it just says accepted. So you don't have to do that, but if you want, the option is there. So yeah, that's how webhooks work. So now I want to show you also an example of something that you can do. So I will just delete this. Then we have here our webhook. And then what we're going to do is we're going to click redetermine data structure. So you will always redetermine the data structure whenever you do something maybe new with that webhook, or like something in your data structure changed. So maybe you have another key value pair, like for example, I don't know, a question someone asked, something like that, then you just click this. But right now, what I want to do is I want to add this webhook to an automation in my email service provider. So I'm using ActiveCampaign. I know that you can also do this with other email service providers, but I just want to demonstrate how cool this webhook module actually is. So over here, inside my automation, what I can do is I can add a webhook module. So I just go over here, I paste this, and I click save. And now what ActiveCampaign is doing, whenever a new contact goes into this automation, then ActiveCampaign is going to send all the contact data over to that webhook. So let me demonstrate that real quick. So I will activate this automation. Then I go to contacts, and then I will find Emma Doe. So here we have Emma Doe, and I will manually, in this case, add this person to that automation. So here, this automation is called webhook example. So I want to add this version to webhook example, and then say okay. And then over here, you see that this thing now says successfully determined. So then now what we can do when we click add another module, for example, right? I could send a personal email to that person with my Gmail account. Like a pretty cool trick that I sometimes use to try to be a bit more personal. Like I would love to send everyone personal messages, but unfortunately I can't, so I try to automate as much as I can. So here I could say send an email, and then here I said to, and then we can map that to email address. So here you see that we have all the data from that webhook from ActiveCampaign. So ActiveCampaign is sending over here the contact, and then we have the contact ID, but also their email address. So then what I can do here is an email address, add okay, and then the subject, then I can just say like any questions. For example, imagine that I'm triggering that webhook whenever someone is visiting my checkout page twice maybe, or they open a certain email, or they reach a certain lead score, whatever, right? Then I can just say like, hey, first name, I noticed that you opened a lot of my emails. Awesome. Nah, and then blah, 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 max. And then, okay. So now when I click save and here I click run once. So run once is just really handy for like testing, especially the webhook module. And if I would now add Emma again to this automation and we go back over here, you see that the webhook module starts. This is the data that we got here. You see ID 31, emma.gmail.com, first name, last name. Okay, all good. And now this email was also sent. So it was sent to Emma Doe. And here you see, hey, Emma, I noticed that you opened quite a lot of emails. And this person would be like, hey, super cool that I'm getting a personal email from Max. So this is just like a handy trick that I wanted to show you. Now then, I want to show you one more example. And this is with my card provider. So I'm using ThriveCard. And what I like to do with ThriveCard, whenever I have a new order, I want to send an order confirmation to that person and also add that person to my email service provider. So to do that, we go over to our webhook module. I copy my webhook, I say redetermine data structure, then I go over to ThriveCard, and then what I can do when I go here in settings to API and webhooks, then here webhooks and notifications, then over here I can say add another webhook, and then here I'd say Integromat, I'll just call this example, and then webhook URL, and then receive result as JSON, so it's like a certain kind of data structure, and then I click save this webhook. And then now, whenever I get a new order, then data is being sent over to my Integromat webhook, and the scenario will start. So let me quickly demonstrate that. So here we have our product, then over here we make sure to click redetermine data structure, and then here I'm going to fill this out, Emma. Doe, somewhere 1, 2, 3, 4, or 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we click PayPal, complete order. And then here, okay, we pay. And then as soon as the data comes, then this will also stop. And then it says, okay, data structure determined. Okay, cool, okay. And then what you can do, again, you can just do everything you want, right? You can maybe create a list of all your customers in Google Sheets. You can send a confirmation email, maybe with the Gmail module. Or what I like to do is then I want to create or update a contact inside ActiveCampaign. So here I already connected it. And then I say email. And then here you see that all the data that we got from ThriveCard. So then here down customer, we see here the email of the customer. And then also the first name of the customer and the last name of the customer. I didn't ask for a phone number, so I'm not going to fill that out. And then here, click OK, and then you would click save. And then if you want to test it again, you can click again on run once. But if this is just what you want to use, this is how you want to use your webhook, this is like your whole scenario, you tested it, you know it's working. Then here, boom, you click scheduling on. And then now whenever there is a new order, the contact will automatically be created inside ActiveCampaign. So yeah, I think that the webhooks inside Integromat are incredibly handy, especially if there's not a native module for the tool that you want to integrate yet. Then you can just create a webhook module, copy the webhook, paste it inside your tool, and then whenever data is sent over, your scenario will automatically start. If you have any questions about webhooks, then make sure to drop them in the comments below and I'll try to help you as best as I can. And if you want to learn more about Integromat, then I also created a full tutorial right here, so you can just click that and then you can learn everything about Integromat there is to know. So that's it for now. I will see you in the next one.